Welcome everyone, Adam Maness here, and today I want to talk about pentatonic shapes, but not just any pentatonic shapes. I want to talk about Kenny Kirkland's pentatonic shapes. Kenny Kirkland, one of the great pianists of the 20th century, of course, super influential on everyone who was his peer and who came after him. And I want to break down a little bit of what he does on just one line from Wynton Marsalis's album, Black Coats from the Underground, Delfeo's Dilemma. It's going to be a good time, and we're going to learn a little bit, I think. At least I did. This, of course, comes with a PDF. You can get that free here in the description. Make sure to download that. That's the entire section here that we have transcribed of Kenny Kirkland's solo, plus a little bit of the breakdown that I'll do on what's happening with the shapes. Of course, like everything we do around here, today's guided practice session is sponsored by Open Studio. Go to openstudiojazz.com for more information on all of this. Okay, so this came up because my friend Peter Martin and I, we did a podcast episode on our favorite albums from the 80s. Stay with me. And one of them was, of course, you can't talk about jazz albums from the 80s without talking about Black Coats from the Underground. And we had a bit of a deep conversation on Kenny Kirkland's solo here on Delfeo's Dilemma. And let's just take a listen here to this podcast episode. I brought up the actual episode to hear the solo because it's fun. It's entertaining for me just to watch Peter Martin listen to Kenny Kirkland play. You'll see what I'm talking about. Here's an excerpt of Kenny's solo here on Delfeo's Dilemma.
Edit, hard edit.
It's so great. This is what we're working on. All of it.
I mean, it's, you know, it's great.
No, we know, Pete, we know. Isn't that great? Just fun watching Peter Martin watch that or listen to that. So we're going to do a very segmented part here. We're just actually going to do over one of these G major 7 sharp 11 chords right here, starting on this second chorus. Transcription here by Max Gamiz. Shout out to Max for hooking us up with this. But that's what we're going to be working on, is how does he play this and what is going on here? I just love that crisp sound here. So that's what we're going to be focusing on. If this is your jam, if this is the kind of stuff you love, why not hit the like and subscribe? Or like and then subscribe. Or subscribe and then like. It doesn't matter. Let's break down what's happening here. So I picked this because it's really cool to see how we might break down how Kenny Kirkland might have been thinking about this. Now, we don't know because we can't talk to Kenny about this, but we can make some assumptions. Turn on my overhead here. We can make some assumptions because there are some very specific shapes that happen over this G major 7 sharp 11, the entire run here. So, of course, G major 7, sharp 11, he's probably thinking Lydian. And then with this line, he proves it. So Lydian, a Lydian major scale, of course, is just like a major scale, but with that sharp 11, with that raised 4. So here in G, it is a C sharp. Now, let's check out here the line. If we break it down, and as pianists, this can be very, very handy. Actually, if you're not a pianist, but you want to kind of like learn how this sound is gotten on the piano, this might be like eye-opening for you to realize that it's a lot of it is shaped-based, like how our hand is shaped. So you can see some shapes here that Kenny is drawn towards as he's playing this line. Right? A add 2, or sometimes we call this A triad plus 1. It's really just an A major triad, A, C sharp, and E, plus this B, right? The 2. And then the same thing here, D add 2. So here in this very first measure of G major 7 sharp 11, we've got this A add 2 triad. And this D add two triad. And then the very next shape, A add two. So he's really, you can almost think about it as going down in these shapes. And then the very next phrase, D. I have D add two there. It's just D triad, but it's, you can kind of think of that same, along those same lines. A add two. And then he adds the F sharp. I don't know if he's thinking F sharp minor here, but that's just kind of the shape plus the B there. So maybe an F sharp minor 11, I don't know. And then back to the A add two. And then back to the D add two to end it. So again, we have just certain shapes. So you could tell he's thinking of that A triad, that D triad, plus that two of each one of those. So on, it's something that we can really actually take with us, because on this Lydian sound, we want this. We can go between sort of this A add two, D add two sound, and we can kind of get what Kenny Kirkland's going for. Not only that, but when we practice this, if we just look at the shapes themselves, we can actually, and will here, go through and just play these shapes. Like getting these positions, you can almost think of them like how a guitarist might think of positions, but getting these positions in our hand, this is something that Peter Martin preaches a lot with his teaching of getting these sort of pentatonic or triad plus one shapes in our hand. Let's just do this really quickly. We'll set our metronome here and just play along here. Let's play these. Get to a piano if you're not at a piano already. And let's just hear how these might sound played all together, getting the shapes of this in our hand before we practice the actual line. Let's do it. Two, three, and. Remember, this is all over a G major 7. So you might put a little G and D here in your left hand. Let's do it again. One, two, three, and. It's getting that G sound there. Isn't that beautiful too? One more time, just the shapes all together. Again, we're just getting these, we're thinking G major 7 sharp 11, and we're getting our A major plus add 2 shape and our D major add 2 shape in our fingers. Two, three, and. It's funny, it's almost the opposite of that intensity that happens when we'll play the actual line. It's very peaceful and beautiful, but you could see where that brightness of the line comes out. All right, let's practice this line here, learning what we know now about these shapes. Let's see if we can play it here in time. I've got the left-hand voicings. Again, shout out to Max for the transcription. Here on G major 7. That's a good tempo. Let's start there. Play with me here. One, two, three, and. Let's try it again. Let's take it up just a little bit. One, two, three, and. Isn't that awesome? All right, man, it plays itself here. A little bit faster each time. One, two, three. I mean, just, you can hear, again, these shapes are all through that. Let's take it up a little bit more. We'll probably stay here and just kind of practice this in a slower pocket. One, two, three, and. Yeah. Try it. I'm just going to play some G major, sharp 11, in the bass here. I'm going to give you a walking bass line. You just loop this for a while. Loop this for a while and see how it works. You might add the left hand voicings. I was really more focusing on the right hand, but if you can get those left hand voicings, it's all just the same voicing. Get those in there where Kenny plays them. Let's try it. I'll do a little walking bass line for you. One, two, three, and. Loop it. Isn't that awesome? That line itself is so killing. It really is. So let's take, again, just going back here towards our shapes, just go back and remember that these are those shapes that we're getting. Now, the real work comes when we want to take this through some other keys, because when we transpose it, say down a whole step, key of F, same thing, F major 7, sharp 11. Like, just knowing that we have that, now it's the on the second degree of an F major 7 sharp 11, so a G triad add 2, and the fifth degree of that F major 7 sharp 11, a C triad add 2, right? These shapes become so crucial. Getting that Kenny Kirkland sound. And then again, remembering the shapes in our hands. So let's just practice here. We're gonna go back down a little bit. Let's just practice these shapes here together like we did in the key of G. Two, three, and. Again, I'm gonna throw some F major sounds there in my left hand so we can hear it against it. E minor at 11 there. Again, this is like an F major 7 sharp 11. We've got a G triad as one of our shapes, major shapes here that he uses to craft the line, and the C. And again, thinking about it, you know, you can see my hands here in one shape. And like, it's just, it makes it so much easier to just kind of break it down to those shapes and then move your hand a certain way. Let's play it again. Two, three, and. One more time, three, and. Thinking F major 7 sharp 11, kind of noting F major 7 sharp 11, and noting these triads and how they work. So beautiful. Okay, isn't that great? So let's take a look at what this line looks like then in the key of F. So here we go. Same thing, let's try playing it. Again, thinking of those G triad add two shapes and C triad add two shapes. Two, three, and. It's So good. Let's try it again a little bit faster. One, two, three, and. Isn't that awesome? A little bit faster here. I'll lay down a bass line. You have fun with this line in F. It's really, really great. One, two, three, and. Just loop it here. Practice it again and again. Again, so just transposing what we learned over that G major 7 sharp 11, how we have the triad add 2 from the second degree and from the fifth degree. And here if we do it in F, again, it's the same thing from the second degree and the fifth degree. And combining those. Right? You can notice how this line starts on the G, then does a C, then does a G, and then does a C. Like it kind of is going between them. Ah, oh, so great. Okay, let's do one more key here. Key of E flat. It's so good to take these things through the keys because it really helps us lock in what are the scale degrees that these triads are based off. So with key of E flat major 7, sharp 11, E flat Lydian sound, F, right, is our second degree triad at 2, F major, F, G, A, and C, and B flat, C, D, and A. So here's our shapes. And of course we have that D minor with that G thrown in, really, which is kind of a combo of those two. Let's try this. Just playing these shapes. Again, this is so important, actually, playing the shapes together, getting them, realizing that you can go between them as shapes themselves, and then just move your hand in different shapes. Skipping, going up, going down. It's all very, very crucial. Let's try it. Two. Three, play with me, and. Adding some E flat sounds here in my left hand so you can hear it again. One more time. Three, and. So beautiful. I mean, it sounds, I can't believe it's the same line when you break it down like that. Okay, so let's check it out in the key of E flat. Let's start right here. One, two, three, and. Thinking of our shapes. Faster now. One, two, three, and. Again, you might even note the shapes here. Let's take it a little bit faster and just maybe note what shapes we're doing here. Two, three, and. F, B flat, F, B flat, F, D minor. Okay, up to a nice respectable swing and tempo. Same thing, you play it, loop it. I'm just gonna loop a little bit of E flat burnout is what we like to call it. Let's try it. One, two, one, two, three, and. There it is, a little burnout language for you. I just want to just really quickly go back here to our very first, just looking at this again now, breaking down that line back in G and checking it out here and just seeing how this A add to, D add to, A add to, D add to, A add to, all of this stuff. How it's just like, again, doing the shapes together. Even if you're not a pianist, go to a piano and look at these shapes like this, play them like this, and then start moving your hand in different ways. It's so funny how like easily this, well, nothing's easy, but you know, like it just fits when you look at it like this, I think. At least it does for me. So thank you so much for practicing. Thanks to the great Kenny Kirkland, as always, for being amazing. And yeah, again, make sure to download the PDF there for yourself. And until next time, everyone, happy practicing.